run in 2003-2004 began with what I truly thought was a wizard in a basketball uniform.
Lindsay Whalen, no! I do not believe that she just did that.
Her sorcery was not just defying the laws of gravity and sheer grit, but it was filling once empty stands into sold-out barn burners. She actually made the Gophers golden and took them to a series of games of which they had never gone before nor since. I mean, do any of you remember 2004? That Duke game in Virginia?
Beautiful pass by Whalen to McCarver. And a lookaway pass to Whalen. Minnesota heading to the Final Four for the first time.
I remember it vividly. Care 11 sent me to cover it. Watching you all cheer that team in a way felt like watching family cheer on their own kin.
Let's go Gophers!
For me, that team, your support of it, being a part of that, made Minnesota begin to feel like home for me for the first time. And as that season ended and Lindsay entered the WNBA with another team, I moved on. My assignment was over until it found a second wind.
Next year, Lindsay Whalen will be wearing the blue and white of the Minnesota Lynx.
Part two, I was assigned the story of Lindsay Whalen in January of 2010. My first report for Whalen round two started out like this.
Lindsay Whalen doesn't know this, but 6 years ago, she became my first friend in Minnesota.
I have never had any chill when it comes to Lindsay Whalen. I know it sounds nuts, but she transcends any game. I saw it in 2004 when she united this state around an underdog team of Minnesota born and raised players. I've seen it for the last 8 years in 6 playoff runs, 4 WNBA titles. Last fall, my zero chill may have dipped into negative numbers.
My friend Lindsay Whalen decided to join us for the end of the show. Thanks for letting me borrow the shirt.
You're welcome. You're welcome. Hey, thank you guys. See ya.
Lindsay Whalen, they never made another better.
And since last year, this season, her 15th and my 15th at CARE, I've wondered how much longer this could last. Well, come this morning, when I woke up, the 15-year dream assignment I'd had was finished. And without knowing what to say, I gathered up all the tapes to get every clip of Lindsay I could find so I could figure out why she meant so much to me. But the reason I found wasn't in those tapes. It was when I saw Coach Reeve begin to cry.
I just feel, you know, like as Lindsay knows, just so lucky to have been able to be a part of such a special career.
I shed a tear too, knowing tonight I can't tell Lindsay Whalen's story. Tonight, like all of us in Minnesota, I can only say thank you, Lindsay.